Thank you, Madam Chairman. And I would certainly concur with the Chairman in terms of the imperative, I think, that many of us feel that we have an opportunity that is in front of us now with our abundant energy resources, whether it is oil, whether it is natural gas. And I appreciate your acknowledgement that energy is truly a source of not only energy security, but national security, and that this nexus here is what propels you to make this next step and accept this nomination that is in front of you today, and recognizing that we have an opportunity to not only help our friends and our allies, as you have suggested, but also help our country from an economic perspective, from a jobs perspective, and really from a perspective of greater self-reliance here. And I do think it takes us right back to the Chairman's point about our opportunities with our oil and most clearly our natural gas. You've mentioned the process that has been underway at DOE with the licensing and the changes to help expedite it. And what I would like from you this morning is a commitment to us that you will work with us here in the Senate to do everything possible, certainly within the bounds and the propriety of the law, to avoid delays as DOE moves forward and finalizes this licensing process and continues to approve the LNG export application. So what I'm trying to do is make sure that we move forward with this process, not take these pauses or timeouts, which I think will limit our ability to utilize our energy resources, not only to our strategic advantage, but to our energy security advantage here.
Senator, I can commit to you that if confirmed, I will work closely with you and members of the committee to ensure that there are no untoward delays in review of proposals for export of LNG.
Would you agree that we have a limited time frame here, or a window of opportunity? If we don't build out our LNG export capacity in a timely fashion, the rest of the world and those who have these resources, they're not just sitting back and waiting for the United States. Would you agree that this is an issue where there is an urgency to it, there is a consideration of timeliness?
Senator, I believe it is a very competitive environment, and I believe we have an opportunity to lead in it.
I concur. Let me ask you a question about WIP. Earlier this week, I sent a letter to Secretary Moniz, and I was inquiring about some of the recent incidences there at DOE's waste isolation pilot project regarding the underground fire. Then there was an unrelated radiological release, pretty alarming, certainly as I read those accounts. Would you be involved in overseeing the investigation and ongoing remedial activities there at WIP?
Senator, thank you for giving me an opportunity to talk about WIP, because it is such an important part of our overall ability to continue the responsibility we have to dispose safely of our nuclear waste. And it is our first operating repository, and so it is very important to us that it be operational. The investigation of what happened this year at WIP is underway. Of course, I don't know exactly when I will be confirmed, but if I am confirmed and it is in a timely fashion, I would have responsibility and support of the Secretary for the investigation, for the recovery and reopening process for the WIP facility. And then I'd say most importantly for the work we need to do going forward in terms of the long-term project of identifying appropriate ways to dispose of our high-level waste, it's the lessons to be learned. One of the signature elements of the work that I do and have done for many years is to take the time to review what lessons can be learned from failure and to apply them going forward so that we can be stronger as we develop new solutions to complex problems.
Well, and Madam Chairman, this issue along with others, but this issue is clearly very timely. When we think about these nominees and the responsibilities that you will have if confirmed, we have Deputy Secretary Poneman, who is leaving, who is involved with this. We need this investigation to go forward. We need to have these ongoing remedial actions. And so making sure that there is that transition from one to another, I think particularly with this incident there at WIP, is key. One last question for you, and this is regards electric reliability, something that I'm quite concerned about and following very intently. Do you support GAO's recommendation for a formal documented process between DOE, FERC, and EPA to interact with respect to the impact of the EPA rules on reliability? GAO had come out with this recommendation.
I am not aware of the GAO report. I am aware of work that is underway on reliability at the Department of Energy, which has been stimulated by a series of experiences, including, for example, Hurricane Sandy, the Metcalf incident, and others, where it has become evident that more effort needs to be applied to ensuring reliability of the grid. That's actually an element of the Quadrennial Defense Energy Review, the Quadrennial Energy Review that the department will be presenting in early 2015, and work is underway on that already. So let me just say that I will be glad to take for the record the question on the GAO report, which I'm not aware of.
Well, just know that this committee follows that very, very closely, and many of us think that we do need to look critically at how all of these agencies interact then with this EPA rule. Thank you, Ms. Sherwood-Randall.